Data modeling involves creating visual diagrams that represent all or part of an information system, highlighting how data points and structures are interconnected. It aims to demonstrate the nature of data in the system, detailing its types, storage relationships, organization methods, and specific attributes and formats. The creation of data models is driven by business requirements. These models are developed with clear rules and needs, established through input from business stakeholders, to ensure they meet the objectives of either a new system or the improvement of an existing one. This process encompasses various levels of detail, starting with gathering business needs from stakeholders and users. These requirements are then converted into data structures, forming a tangible database design. A data model is akin to a roadmap, an architect's plan, or any detailed diagram that aids in understanding the design's intricacies. Standardized schemas and formal methods are employed in data modeling. This standardization ensures a uniform, reliable approach to managing data resources within an organization or even externally. Data models are dynamic, evolving with the changing requirements of a business. They are crucial for supporting business operations and guiding IT architecture and strategy planning. Moreover, these models can be shared with external entities like vendors, partners, or industry colleagues for broader collaboration and consistency. Let's explore the stages involved in data modeling. Stage 1. Requirements gathering. Before embarking on data modeling, we need to know the end use case requirements. This stage involves understanding the needs and objectives of stakeholders, the information they seek, and how they'll use it. Analysis of the data sources ensures that correct data sources are selected to meet the end use case requirement. Stage 2. Conceptual design. After understanding the end use case requirements and analyzing the selected data sources, we begin the stage of conceptual data modeling. This stage focuses on the what rather than the how. Conceptual design defines the broad landscape of information needs, identifying key entities and their relationships. Conceptual data models, sometimes called domain models, paint a broad picture of what a system will look like. They act as a roadmap, outlining the system's content, organization, and underlying business rules. At their core, conceptual models define the key data entities, things important to the business, and their attributes, specific details about those entities. They also map out the relationships between these entities, ensuring data consistency and security. Entities are the main actors in the data story. Customers, products, orders, employees are examples of entities, the fundamental building blocks of the data model. Attributes represent the information that defines each entity. For example, a customer entity will typically have name, address, age as attributes. Product name, product description, weight are examples of the attributes of a product entity. Relationships define how these entities interact. Customers place orders, products belong to categories, employees work in departments. These relationships link the entities together, depicting the flow of information. Conceptual models typically use simple notation to be easily understood by both technical and non-technical stakeholders. This way, everyone involved can have a clear understanding of the system's core data concepts and how they interact. In essence, conceptual data models bridge the gap between business needs and technical implementation. They act as a vital first step in ensuring the system is built around the right data and optimized for the business it serves. Conceptual data modeling tools like entity relationship diagrams, ERDs, help to visualize the entities and their connections. This initial stage guides the next stages of data modeling, ensuring everyone involved has a clear understanding of the overall data landscape. Stage 3. Logical design. Now, we delve deeper into the how of our data model. We refine the conceptual map, adding more detail and structure. A logical data model establishes the structure of data elements and the relationships among them. It is independent of the physical database. Data types describe the kind of information we are dealing with. Numbers, text, dates, images are examples of data types of the attributes. For example, the customer name attribute has a data type of text. Product weight attribute has a data type of number. Defining data types ensures accuracy and efficient storage. Constraints are the rules that govern the data in the attributes. Unique identifiers, mandatory fields, minimum or maximum values are examples of constraints. For example, a customer name attribute could be defined as mandatory to have data populated in a customer entity. Constraints help to safeguard data integrity and consistency. Primary and foreign keys help to interconnect the tables. Primary keys uniquely identify each record in a table, while foreign keys reference those IDs in other tables, establishing relationships and enabling accurate data retrieval. Logical data modeling bridges the gap between the high-level conceptual view and the specific technical implementation. Some projects, like those in agile environments, might opt to skip this stage and jump straight to physical design. However, logical models shine in projects heavily reliant on data, like data platforms, data warehouse design, or reporting systems. They provide a well-structured foundation for these data-driven endeavors. Stage 4. Physical design. Think of them as the final blueprint translating the logical ideas into actual database structures. This is where data gets its very own home, organized in tables and columns so it's accessible and efficient. This stage is all about choosing the right tools and implementing our model in a specific database technology like MySQL, Oracle. Starting with database platform, scalability, security, performance, are the key factors which influence the database platform selection. Then we go in the nuts and bolts, data types, lengths, primary keys, foreign keys, everything needed to make the data work in a real-world database. On the data attributes are finalized, we make the data relationships real. Remember those important connections between entities? Physical models bring them to life using specialized, associative tables, making clear how different pieces of data interact and depend on each other. Physical models take those into account, specifying details like performance tuning options to ensure the data syncs in its chosen home. Then we start thinking about how can we speed up data retrieval? Defining indexes and optimizing queries ensure our ship sails smoothly through the data ocean. These models aren't just pretty pictures. They're ready to execute plans, complete with instructions for creating tables, setting up relationships, and optimizing performance. Physical data modeling requires expertise in specific database technologies. It's where the rubber meets the road, bringing our information map to life and enabling us to interact with and analyze the data. Stage 5. Implementation and optimization. We populate the database with data, test its functionality, and ensure it meets our requirements. This stage involves tuning queries for efficiency and performance, making sure our ship navigates the data ocean smoothly. Throughout the journey, we employ various techniques to ensure our map is accurate and useful. Normalization, organizing data to minimize redundancy and ensure data integrity. Data cleansing, removing errors and inconsistencies from the data. Data warehousing, consolidating data from multiple sources for analysis. Dimensional modeling, creating data structures optimized for specific analysis tasks. Data modeling is an iterative process. We may need to adjust our course as we encounter new information or changing needs. But with the right tools and techniques, we can transform the vast ocean of data into a navigable sea, revealing valuable insights and guiding us towards informed decision-making. Remember, data modeling is not just about technology, it's about understanding the business and its information needs. It's a collaborative journey, where data modelers and stakeholders work together to create a map that leads to success. So, set sail, embrace the data, and let the insights flow.